Hey, we're going on a trip. Hey YouTube. What's up? Okay. Alright, what are we doing tonight?
Oh, I can't. It's a secret actually. I didn't tell Rachel what we're doing, so.
But we look cute.
Yeah, so we're stopping at this brewery in Hammond, Indiana, and we're gonna drink some beer, and we're grumpy as hell, and the beer's gonna be good.
We've been talking about doing this for months. Hey YouTube, what's up? Welcome back to my channel. So a few weeks ago, before school and life just got too busy to work on this, my partner Declan and I went to Chicago for the weekend so that they could do this huge conference thing that I don't really know much about, other than that it was stressful and really cool because they got to have a poster in it. I was like, I'm gonna spend the whole weekend in Chicago, not at this conference, but sort of at the conference. Actually, not at all at the conference. I never went in. So we stayed in this like cute little Airbnb on the north side, and it was like in this guy's apartment, and it was really nice. It was really cozy. Since my partner and I are gonna be moving soon, and we're gonna be far away from Chicago, and right now we only live 3 hours away, I was like, I'm just gonna enjoy the things that I can, like today and tomorrow, and just kinda do things that I've never done in Chicago before, because I've done all the museums, I've done all the cool walks or whatever you want to say, but I never really like enjoyed a nice day in Chicago, and so I walked everywhere. We went to this like donut shop that just kind of makes me think of the movies where like people are literally yelling like their order and then they're just kind of like throwing their donuts at them. And we got like a coffee and a donut, and I'm like really zero waste too, and this trip was not very zero waste. I tried my best. I didn't bring my coffee cup. That was the problem. But you gotta take the small victories. And then we like walked to the conference, I dropped them off, and then I was like, I'm gonna go to Millennium Park. I think that's what people do. I met this guy there while I was taking pictures, and he ended up telling me like how he was from Dallas and he's going to Africa to live out of a truck. Actually, I think he's probably coming home soon, because he rented like this truck with like a camping set in it for like 3 or 4 weeks, and he was gonna be like in some country in Africa doing that. So I like walked around a bit, I saw the bean. Everyone always makes a big deal about the bean. It's really just a piece of metal, but I guess it's well made. I won't discredit it too much. So I walked over to this place called Native Foods, and I had an amazing meal. It was like cauliflower, orange cauliflower on fried rice or something. It was super good. And I ended up meeting this family who was eating there, whose son was vegetarian, but none of the rest were anything, but the whole restaurant was vegan. So they're all like eating there together, which I think is super cool. I like when like families accommodate or even like eat your kind of food if you're vegan or vegetarian, instead of making you accommodate and eat their food, or like go to a place that has like one option for you. And then I got coffee with a friend from my partner's program, and it was really nice. We went to this place that had like these paintings on the walls that were like pictures of celebrities that were injured. It was very strange. Like there was one with like Snooki with a neck brace on, and like, and then I went home and I was so tired. And then my partner came back to the Airbnb and they were so tired, and we were like, oh, let's not go out tonight. But it was really the only night that we had to go out. And then Declan was like, Okay, I got a plan. Let's go out. I have three bars in mind. We don't have to hit all three of them. We can go to just one. And I was like, okay, I can handle just one bar. So we walked to this place. It's like a wine bar. It's super cute, super fancy. There's like dangly lights everywhere. And we just kind of chatted over like a glass of wine. And then like there was just like all of this energy. We didn't want to go home. We wanted to go to the next bar. So Declan like led me to this bar that like looked really divey, and I was like, okay, interesting choice. And we walk in and Declan's like, oh, we need to go to the bathroom. And I'm over here being like the extreme feminist that I can be, and I'm like, I need to go to the bathroom. Why are you telling me I need to go to the bathroom? And I'm getting like actually frustrated with them. And next thing you know, like we're walking down the stairs because I'm like still very baffled as to why we need to go. And this like bookshelf on the wall just like swings open, and this like very fancy dressed woman, like sleek as heck, comes out of the bookshelf and like closes the door, or more so the bookshelf, and like immediately asks us if we like have a name or whatever, like have a spot. And I'm just like, what the heck is going on right now? And hold on, one moment, coffee break. And Declan's like, oh no, we need to get one. Like, can you put us on the list? And she like took our name down and then like went back into the bookshelf. And I'm like,
wait a second.
Okay, bookshelf, fancy dress lady. Okay, there's a bar back there. And so we're waiting for our table, and then next thing you know, it's our turn. So we go downstairs and this lady like leads us into this like tiny, tiny bar with this like, it was so, honestly, I thought it was so romantic and like exotic also, because it was like so dimly lit, and then there was this massive curtain in the back that had like this burlesque like movie in black and white. And then like the drinks were on tarot cards, and so you like chose which tarot card you wanted, and they were all like super fancy drinks. I had never heard of like any of the things in them other than like orange peel, ginger beer. I ended up getting like a orange and ginger beer drink with like stuff in it that I don't even know to this day. And my partner ended up getting this like drink, I think it was scotch by chance, that the woman who owned the place, who also happened to be our server, like foraged for the ingredients in Scotland. Like, and it had like all these different like wild like plants in it, like lavender and who knows what else. There was just all these flowers and leaves in this drink. The coolest part though was it was like a really intimate setting, so we had like a lot of nice conversation, but then they had like a live show go on for like 15 minutes of the hour, every hour. And so there was like this burlesque show that went on while we were sitting in there, and it was like my first time ever seeing anything like that, my first time ever being to a speakeasy, and like, felt pretty great. I was having a really good time. Come here. This is Bella. Say hi. She just ate breakfast. We took the train to Chicago Diner, which is like a well-known vegan restaurant in Chicago, up on the north side by the Cubs Stadium, and it's all like comfort food. So like, I got this Cuban sandwich that was like delicious. It had banana peppers on it, which was my favorite part probably. I love banana peppers. And my partner got like this massive, I'm talking massive, like country fried seitan steak. It was so, oh my gosh, all the food was so good. And then we headed on home. It's a 3-hour drive, and majority of that drive consisted of us listening to like extreme throwbacks from like our very scene, like middle school days. And yet like we knew every single word to every single song still. And so yeah, it was a really great trip. I had a great time, but there are some more travels coming up extremely, extremely soon. So I am glad that you watched this video. I'm glad to see you back. I hope you all have a wonderful day.